Hello guys, it's me, Mr. Yar, and today I'm going to be showing you guys how to make homemade gunpowder, okay? So it's a very simple process, but what you will need is some sulfur, which you can get at your local garden store, some Spectacide stump remover, which you can also get at your local garden store, and I'm just gonna do this. Some charcoal. Okay. First, what you will need to start the process, my camera's falling. Don't fall. Is 10 grams of sulfur. So, put a thing on there. Start that up. And, oh, good god, I shouldn't have done it on this. Yeah. There we go. Now, you zero it out so that there's no weight. See, now I push on it and there's weight. Use a bowl. And, 10 grams of sulfur. So here's the sulfur. I should use an opening bottle. Now, start pouring. Oh, wait, let me... In there, 10 grams of sulfur. The next ingredient is 15 grams of very, very finely powdered and ground up charcoal. So that's what I have here. It's pretty fine. I did this like a few months ago, my first time, and then my brother made some charcoal. Charcoal, pour in 15 grams. So this should go up to 25. Yeah, that's roughly 25. Can be a bit over. Yeah. There. 25-ish grams of charcoal. Now, this part is a bit more tricky. You need 75 grams of potassium nitrate, or this stump remover, but you have to pour out 75 grams and then bake it in an oven for 25 minutes at 250 degrees. So, let's go do that. Okay guys, so yeah, I moved to a better counter space. Sorry that's a bit dirty, but what you'll need next is your Spectacide stump remover or potassium nitrate, and this has that in it. So, you will need 75 grams of that stuff, and I'm using this pan to cook it in. So, yeah, and you're gonna, after you have 75 grams, you're gonna need to bake it for 25 minutes at 250 degrees. So, 75 grams. Baked at 250 degrees for me. I'm gonna put a little too much in. Okay. 75 grams. Now, take it. You come to your oven. Open it up. Slide the potassium in. I do not want enough to use it. 250, time cooking at 25 minutes. Now, you do, close it up. Okay guys, so, well, it's done, and yeah. And I'm filming the oven while I try to put on an oven mitt. So, always be careful. Can't freaking open it. Okay. Well, there it is. Looks like nothing caught on fire. Oh, it's hot. There. Now. Doesn't look cooked, but you need to bake it to get the moisture out of it, because obviously moisture and something that's supposed to catch on fire doesn't mix at all. Yeah, it's just a given common sense. Okay, so I'm just gonna aim it there, the camera. So now we have this stuff. I'm gonna touch that. And that stuff. Yeah. Well, let me just get everything centered. I did not get prepared. And I hope I'm not missing a step. That's good enough. Now, with... Oh, it's not that hot. With your mixture. Stir it. So, I'll come back. It'll be stirred in 3, 2, 1. Boom, it's stirred. Yay. So, this is what it looks like when it's stirred. I wasn't able to get all the chunks ground down because that's pretty hard. But... yeah, let's go outside and light a bit off. Okay guys, when you do this, make sure you have a parent guardian around and it's not very windy, because this stuff will blow around a bit. But without further ado, okay, for some reason whenever I make it, it doesn't catch on fire that quick, but it works fine. Okay, and once it's burning, I mean, yeah, it's a kind of slow burn, but if you ever put this like in something, it'll give a bang. Yep. It leaves these weird spots around whenever you light it off. That's kind of a dead giveaway. Your parents ask you, what's this spot doing on the ground? Then you know you're caught. But yeah. Well, that's the end of this video. And like and subscribe.